he had the same duty to this council. That is by law. That is by the law, by the rules of professional conduct that we operate in as a lawyer. It is by the rules of the state of laws of Louisiana. He had to get a written waiver. The argument, sir, with all due respect, that Mr. Roy sit in this room with EMS while millions of dollars in contract was being discussed and never once crossed the line into being into representing EMS is not supported by the record. But for the sake of argument, even if he sit in that room and he never ever represented anybody but Sam Sansing, that conflict still existed because he had access to information as a private attorney that he could now use as a mayor to benefit his client. That rule, sir, as a lawyer, is not a gray area. It is there for a very specific reason to prevent exactly what has happened in this case. A lawyer does not get to sit in the room and watch everything surround him and say, okay, now that I'm in the room, I don't have a conflict because I never lifted the hand. That's not how it worked. Mayor Roy was in that room. The documents and the testimony is clear. He actively represented Sam Sansing and EMS, which he should have. I draw no problem with the conduct of Mayor Roy as a private attorney. As I stated in my statements, he did a damn good job of representing his client's interests. The problem is, when he crossed that line, he should have immediately ceased any representation of them. He should have immediately came to this council and asked them for a written waiver.
Any other questions, Mr. Fowler?
You're saying that he did represent EMS then?
I don't think there's any doubt. In my opinion, he represented EMS.
Had a contract with him. He received funds from him.
Let me tell you how it works as a lawyer again. Again, I'm not talking down to you, okay? If you call me on the phone and you ask me for some advice and I give you that advice, I'm now your lawyer. I now have a duty of confidentiality to you. I now have a duty to give you advice that is free of conflict. The role of a lawyer is one of the most powerful in this society. It is why the Louisiana State Bar Association 15 years ago, and the lawyers on this committee will tell you, the body that governs our conduct, we hate them. And the reason why we hate them is because they are the policemen, and they are the final arbiter, and they impose the rules on our conduct. We don't get to play around the gray area. So once, as a lawyer, if I give you advice, all the rules that govern my professional relationship and my law license now kick in. I need not take $1 from you. Most lawyers will tell you, Mr. Councilman, that we spend 40% of our time giving advice and never get paid. But the duty still, that it doesn't matter whether or not we signed a contract or we got paid. The obligations under the rules of professional conduct and this charter kicks in.
All right. Any other questions, Mr. Fowler?
No.
Gentlemen, any questions or comments?
Comment.
You have a quick comment, Mr. Goins, please address your comment.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I've heard uncontroverted facts on today. And at this point, I'd just like to make a motion that the legal chairman prepare a report along with recommendations and present it to the full council. To deliberate as to whether or not a conflict exists, and at that point, prepare a report or submit documents in writing to the appropriate agencies.
You heard the motion by Mr. Goins. Do you have a second? At this time, I'm going to transfer chairmanship to Mr. President. I'll make the motion, ask for the vote.
You've heard the motion made by Mr. Goins. Is it second to the motion?
Second.
Probably second by Mr. Lauberdane. Discussion. Hearing none. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Motion carries.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, the Council, for your time.
Is there anything coming before legal? A quick question, comment? We're running out of time.
Yeah.
Okay. There being none, legal's adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lauberdane.